I don't think that Dewey knew what he was doing was revolutionary when it was. At the time, he didn't know it. We know it now, it's easy to look back, but all Dewey was doing was playing his taste, and his taste was mixing everything up, and if it felt good, wear it, and he played it. It was always my observation that he never referred to his audience in any other way but as good people. It wasn't African-American people, it wasn't white people, it wasn't Latin people, it was good people. They were all good people. And so Dewey had no, I mean, he could walk down Beale Street and they would all want to talk to him. And this is in the days where there were very few white people on Beale Street. So to me, that just sort of shows you that as Sam and rock and roll and Memphis were breaking down racial barriers and musical categories, Dewey was played a big role in breaking down racial barriers and musical categories on radio in Memphis, and the people loved it. The good people loved it. He was always doing something on radio that sort of bothered the establishment at times. They loved him, but he was always sort of over the line a little bit. I guess the best story I remember about Dewey, and I was listening when this happened, he told everybody, he said, "Okay, good people," he said, "now it's 9:30, and we are going to all blow our horns in Memphis at 10 o'clock. He said, "I want you to all blow your horns at 10 o'clock. I don't care where you are, if you're in the drive-in, just blow them." Now, everybody listened to Dewey in those days. They really did. He had a huge audience. And about 5 minutes later, the chief of police called. His name was Chief McDonald. And he said, "Dewey, man, you can't be doing that. We have an anti-noise law in Memphis. It's 10 o'clock at night. People, you know, get up early and go to work." He said, "Okay, Chief." So he gets on the radio knowing full well after that record he got on and says, "Good people, Chief McDonald just called and he said we cannot blow our horns on at 10 o'clock tonight." And he said, "We have an anti-noise law in Memphis." He said, "We just really can't do it, so don't blow your horns at 10 o'clock. He said, "Now, I can't tell you not to blow your horns if you really want to. It's a free country, so I can't tell you not to. But Chief McDonald doesn't want us to, and we probably should do what he says," and that was it. So of course 10 o'clock comes, and man, you could open the window and you could hear an aura of horns all over the city. I mean, all he had to do was say, "Don't do it," and it was a done deal, and Dewey knew it. He was the total living embodiment of the maverick independent spirit of Memphis. And he was a larger than life character around here in Memphis. And for that reason, most people focused on his flamboyance, but he was off the wall, brilliant, genius talent that was crazy good.
His vision meets her voice at Broadway's most exciting new hit, Memphis.
Memphis, live on the Orpheum stage, October 14th through the 23rd. Call us at 525-3000 and do it today.